Gene Cornish, ladies and gentlemen. Sit down after that one there, pal. Sit down right there. Bring it on. How are you, man?
I am great. I've had the greatest year in my life. Rascals got back together after 42 years. I got engaged for the first time in my life.
You're kidding!
The lovely Debbie Davis out there in the audience.
Yeah, Debbie.
I'm gonna turn 70 years old next month.
Oh my God.
You buying that shit?
Well, yeah. Sunday night 7-8, we're on in TV. The great thing about, you know what I loved about you guys is that in a 5-year period when you guys were lightning hot, you did 17 singles, you did 8 albums, and there was really a tremendous amount of pressure on you guys to keep on cranking out those hits.
Well, you've done your homework.
I've done my homework.
You know, back in the day when you had to have a hit record every 4 months, and knock on wood, we were blessed with the writing of Cavalieri and Brigatti. Mm. Eddie Brigatti, a Jersey boy, also from Garfield.
Yeah.
Dino Danelli from Jersey City.
Yeah.
And Phyllis Cavalieri from Pelham, New York. And myself from Ottawa, Canada, originally grew up in Rochester, lived in Manhattan for 30 years, and now I live in New Jersey.
Well, we love you here.
So I must tell you, the work ethic was different than bands now can make a record, wait 3 or 4 years, make another record. The competition was so stiff. We had to compete with the Lovin' Spoonful, a Dave Clark Five, God forbid, the Beatles, we couldn't even compete with them, the Rolling Stones, the Animals, all those bands. We did 17 hit singles in a row, 8 gold and platinum albums in a row in 5 years, and the record company said we were lazy.
Oh my God. But I mean, as with many, many groups, there was a little bit of a conflict, and then you guys decided to call it quits. And
the pressure was so big on us, and we had so many people we had to take care of. And it was in the time when the business was not the business. It was still a baby industry.
Yeah.
We were young. We got very, very popular. And we kind of like thought we knew it all at some point. And we had some kind of disagreement. I don't remember what it was about.
Doesn't matter now, does it?
But Steve Van Zandt, of course, Jersey Steve Van Zandt, that is.
Little Steven.
His dream was to put the Rascals back together for at least 30 years. He inducted us in the Hall of Fame. He got us back together 3 years ago to play the Kristen Ann Carr Foundation Cancer benefit. I'm a cancer survivor myself, so we did this. Yeah, thank you. I've been very blessed. Stevie put us together 3 years ago to do a show. We rehearsed for 3 days. We loved it so much. We said, Steven, if you have an idea to do something very special, not just the oldies show, not just the reunion show, get back to us. It took him 2 years, and he came up with a show called Once Upon a Dream. Yeah. Anybody see Once Upon a Dream?
Yeah.
Well, you know, it was a bio concert. It was something that Broadway was not ready for.
Yeah.
We wound up the third week of ticket sales with 37 shows on Broadway. We came in number 4 in ticket sales that time. And they couldn't ignore us. They put us on the Tonys, and then Whoopi Goldberg came to see us in Toronto. And we played for her birthday on The View. Wow. We did 70 shows. We played over 150,000 people. And we played the PNC here. We were all over the country. We had the greatest time in the world. And we're planning some more stuff. So. One other thing I want to say that Tim McClune has asked me to come back here. It'll be on the schedule next week. I'm going to be here for a question and answer on the Master Series.
The Music Master Series, yeah.
And of course, I'm going to invite Bobby Bandieri and the boys to come back and to play with me.
Oh, that'd be huge.
I hope I will see you all here. Look on the schedule. It will be on. Sammy Boyd, my dear friend Sammy Boyd, told me today that I'll definitely be here very, very soon.
Well, we're happy that you have Bobby and, of course, playing with the big band. But more importantly, as a music fan, thank you for all getting together. I don't know if you remember, but Pat and I did a show. We did a show actually before you got together. We did a show up in Sayreville. It was a documentary.
Yeah, with the documentary, we were we're all kind of wallowing, doing Rascal songs. We all had different Rascal bands out there, and we did a DVD which hasn't come out, and I hope it doesn't, because now the Rascals are back together, and that's the real deal. But anyway, I remember doing that show with you for the first time.
Yeah.
I love what you did then. I love what you do now, and thank you so much.
Gene, thank you. Thank you for being on the show.